to have such an all-encompassing belief that I'm a complete failure, it's false. It doesn't make sense.
How do you deal with these people?
Yeah, there's a difference between depression, like major depressive disorder, and bipolar disorder, right? Ah. So although the symptoms look alike, especially when a bipolar person is having the depression stage, right?
Okay.
It's the same manifestations, like it's still the same thing. But how we treat the two of them is very different. Imagine someone with depression, right? They go see a psychiatrist and they get anti-depression medication. Makes sense. So they take it, they balance out the neurotransmitters, and then they feel better after that. Now, if this person with bipolar disorder isn't diagnosed properly, and it's very common, right? So obviously when you're on a high, you're not going to go see a therapist more because I'm feeling good, right? I only see a therapist when I feel crappy, right? And that's when they're in the depressed stage. So they go see a psychologist or psychiatrist, they get diagnosed with depression, and then they also get anti-depressant medication. That's really dangerous because remember how I talked about how with bipolar disorder, you're oscillating between depression and on a high, right?
Yeah.
If you're depressed, you take depression medication as a bipolar patient, your depression jumps up to, like, it ends, like, it gets treated, right? Your high gets amplified tenfold, right? Because it's like you bring everything up, right? And I think when that happens, right, the fallout from that is spectacular, right? Unfortunately,
right.
Because it feels so amazingly good when they finally do crash, right? Everything is just amplified, right? The depression is so much more intense. So I think when we talk about depression, we need to separate the two.
Okay, okay. We need to classify them
separately.
Separately.
Yeah. Yep. So to answer your original question, how do we treat them, right? For me, the work that I do CBT, cognitive behavior therapy, right? I try and find out what's the underlying reasons. So if regardless of whether you're depressed because you're MDD, major depressive disorder,
yeah,
or depressed because you've got a bipolar disorder, right? There are reasons why you are like that, right? And for CBT, for example, we say that there's an underlying belief that you have. It's usually either I'm useless or I'm unlivable. That's the core belief that we have. Ultimately, all of us here would have either one of those. So you have that, I have that, right? And that drives all our behaviors, our emotions, our reactions and whatnot. If your core belief, let's say hypothetically, is I'm useless, like, and you live your life based on that belief, like, that's not true. No matter how big a failure you are, you're going to have some successes along the way, whether it be in terms of good friendships or getting up in the morning, brushing my teeth, putting on clothes and going off to work. That's a success story on its own.
Yeah.
So to have such an all-encompassing belief that I'm a complete failure, it's false. It doesn't make sense. So as a therapist, I try and help you find out what that is and then try and smooth out the edges a little bit and find something a bit more rational. And that balances our life, which is what makes sense.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. Glad you liked it. Now, if you want to check out a full discussion on all our other episodes, click right here. And of course, don't forget to subscribe.